Hi guys, I hope everyone is okay. As you remember, the first version of ZPM was very different from other machines we are experimenting with, because its input coils were also the output coils. So in the next experiments I've made, I tried to separate the input coils from output coils. So I tried many configurations. For example, I tried to put this one as input coil here in the middle of the core. It has about 20 turns from 1.4 millimeters wire. The thing about this was it has very high voltage on output, about 600 volts, and I had bluish sparks and bluish color in the output lights. For example, this is what happened. So you can imagine it was a failed experiment. And I tried many other things as input coils. So far they didn't work very well, and currently I'm trying this configuration. Basically what I have here is an input coil put over the output coils. So the output coils are actually the initial coils. They have the same configuration like before. This coil, the small coil, has about 150 turns. This one has the same 300 turns. And over these coils I have the input coil, which has about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 turns, and it's 8 shape, or like infinity symbol. So basically is like this. Okay. The reason I made this was because I wanted the input magnetic field to oppose when it's generated, just like the output coils, which have opposing magnetic fields. So let me show you the connections. From the MOSFET driver, I have the input, which is here. So no electrical connection between the input and the output coils. As you can see, these are the ends of the input coil. Okay, on output I have the output coils connected here. This is the connection between them, and the other ends of the output coils are going directly to the output. This one and this one. For output, I switched to 220 volts light bulb, just like the one we are using here in Europe. Because I wanted to go to the next level. For now, the results are not spectacular. I am gonna show you, but it's a good beginning. So let me show you how it works in this initial configuration. For input, I'm using for now 166 kilohertz. Amplitude is 20 volts. And I'm working with a duty cycle of 50%. So for the start, this is what the DC source is showing me. Of course, this is not real real data, as you can know, as before. And I have nothing on output. The interesting thing is, if I'm shorting the big coil, something like this. See, here is the end of the one end of the bigger coil, and this is the other end of the bigger coil. I have something like this. The other interesting thing is if I'm using this capacitor, sorry, the light is much stronger. This is what I found so far. What I don't understand is how, why putting the bigger coil in short, I have results. Basically, it shouldn't happen. But still, here it is. About this, sorry. About this capacitor, I tried many. This is how it looks like. I will try other configurations. This is just a temporary configuration. I think I will give up on using this 8-shaped input coil, and I will put half of the coil like this, and then continue like this. So basically, this is the schema which works. In this configuration, I know it's not much, it's not spectacular, but keep in mind this is usual light bulb we are using in our homes, so I consider this is a beginning. Now I'm gonna pause the video because I want to put the oscilloscope probes on it and show the interaction between the coils. Okay, I'm back. So the first thing, after connecting the oscilloscope probes, it's something strange. I see a spike in consumption from the DC source. At least what the DC source is showing me. See, it's about 2 amperes. So in order to decrease this consumption, I'm gonna change the frequency. Find another frequency. Let me see. I don't know if you can see both the DC source display and the sine generator. I will do it like this. Okay. Oops. Okay. So the new frequency is 119 kilohertz. And this is what I have on oscilloscope. So basically the big coil, output coil, is yellow and the small coil is blue. Keep in mind the signals are inverted because I have the ground from oscilloscope here in the middle between on the connection between coils. And the probes are on opposite direction. So this is what I have. I'm gonna pause the video again so I can show what the both coils are showing on oscilloscope. Basically the output. So after connecting the oscilloscope probes on the output, basically both output coils, I needed to change the frequency again. Now it's 132 kilohertz, and this is what it's showed me. So it's almost 300 volts point to point. And I will pause the video again to show you what oscilloscope is showing me on the input coil. And this is what I have on the input coil. By the way, I needed to change the frequency again after connecting the oscilloscope on the input. By the way, this is the light bulb I'm using now, and I intend to use in the future for experimenting. So it's about 70 watts. So this is it. I know it's nothing spectacular, but I consider it's a good beginning. I will continue to experiment with the input coil and different configurations, maybe different capacitors. I don't know. I will keep experimenting to get better results. And that's all. Stay safe for everyone there, okay?